So you want to make an audio amplifier. So you want you have a small input voltage and you want a higher output voltage. What you could use is indeed an op amp to do that. So, but you only have a single supply, but your signal goes from 20 millivolts to minus 20 millivolts. So as we know, if we just put the signal at the input, the non-inverting input, so this will be a non-inverting amplifier. So we add the resistors. The formula is already showing. So we make the upper R1 100k and the lower one 10k. And we add the ground here and finish the feedback path. And then we add at the output decoupling, or actually just AC decoupling or coupling, so that we lose our DC offset around here. We make this about 100 microfarads, this 100k. You could call this a load. It's not really a load. It's just mainly there to make sure that this capacitor has a chance to lose its charge to ground when there's nothing connected. So if we look at the input, let's run a simulation. Look at the input. We got our signal, 20 millivolts. Oh. 20 millivolts, minus 20, 20. We have our amplifier. We look at the output and we see that it's doing its best to go to 20 to amplify, but the negative cycle goes wrong because the amplifier cannot go under 0 volt because there's our lowest voltage in the circuit. So at the output of the circuit we will have some kind of weird clipped wave. But what we want is to have this just the full wave without the clipping. So what we have to do is make sure that the input signal is shifted above 0 volts. So what we'll do is remove this connection, add a capacitor, and then make it like this. The usual value could be 100 nanofarads. So what we did now is we decoupled this AC part of the circuit of this part of the circuit, so we can add voltages here, DC voltages. Because we have a 9 volt battery source, for example, we can add a voltage divider. And we make the values of each resistor about 100k. You have to be careful with these values, because if you go too low, you will mainly pretty much just make a very large current run from plus to minus, and that will make sure that your battery gets drained pretty fast. So this will be 4.5 volts. So that we add here. And we have to inject this voltage in this line here. So we add another resistor with a nice high value. And then the voltage there. Now if we look again, we see that our input voltage is fine. 0 to 20, 0 to minus 20. And here it's doing exactly the same, but at half the supply voltage. So what if we now look at the output? Will it now be fine, or will there still be a problem? Sadly, our output is hard clipped at 9, almost the supply voltage. So what is happening here? Because this amplifier just amplifies anything, it doesn't just look at the AC, but it also looks at the DC that's going through it. So if we do amplify the DC times 11, we get a value way higher than 9 volts, and that's why you get this massive clipping here. To make sure that this amplifier just doesn't care about DC but only the AC, we can add a capacitor here at ground, like this. Make it a nice value. And now we're going to run the simulation again. And we see that we have a nice output voltage around our bias voltage at the input. So here's our input voltage, 0 to 20, biased at 4.5 volts, so you get just a DC offset. And then amplified 11 times, only the AC component yields us this output voltage, and then we remove the DC offset of this waveform again, and we end up with a nice amplified signal. And if we look, do the math, you can see that 220 divided by 20 is indeed 11. So it works.